So the next one is decomposition reaction. Let us understand what is a decomposition reaction by an example. Okay, I have ferrous sulfate. The formula of ferrous sulfate is FeSO4. I am going to take this ferrous sulfate in a test tube. The color of ferrous sulfate is green, light green. What happens is, when you heat it, you have to just heat it without adding water or something. Just heat it, it becomes Fe2O3 plus SO2 plus SO3. So this is oxide of iron, this is the oxide of sulfur, right? So sulfur dioxide and iron oxide, right? So guys, this is color will be brown, and these will be gases, and they will give a smell. They will give a smell of burning sulfur. They will give a smell of burning sulfur. Right? So what is happening here? You take crystals of ferrous sulfate, which is light green color. You heat it and you are going to get 1, 2, 3 products. You are getting the 3 products out of a single reactant. A single reactant is there, but product are more than 2. So such reaction is called decomposition reaction. Basically, this has decomposed to form 2 or more products. What you can say? But how can you define decomposition reaction? Decomposition reaction is a reaction in which a single reactant is broken down to form more than 2 products. So that is known as decomposition reaction. In decomposition reaction, we have different types. That the first one is thermal decomposition. Thermal decomposition. So what do we mean by thermal decomposition? Thermal means, therma means heat. Thermal from therma means heat. Thermometer. You must have heard. Understood? Thermal decomposition. So guys, in this reaction, FeSO4 become Fe2O3 and SO2 and SO3 by heating it. Right? If you don't heat it, you will not have become these things. Right? So here the application of heat is making this. So if this reaction is carried out by heating, then that decomposition reaction is called thermal decomposition. So thermal decomposition reaction is the reaction carried out by heating. Carried out by what? Heating. If a reaction is carried out just by heating, then that reaction is known as thermal decomposition. So this one is a good example for thermal decomposition. We can also give one more example for thermal decomposition. The example is CaCO3. CaCO3 is your calcium carbonate. So when you heat it, when you heat calcium carbonate, what happens is it is going to decompose into CaO and CO2. Okay. Here also we have single reactant, but the product are 2 or more than 2. It is the exact opposite of that of a combination reaction. In the combination reaction, a single 2 or more reactants combined to form a single product, but in the decomposition reaction, a single reactant breaks down to form more than 2 products. 2 or more than 2 products. Right? So this is also an example for thermal decomposition. Right? So we can give one more example of thermal decomposition. You guys have to learn to balance these equations. This are for you. Next, one more example I will give you of what is CaCO3? Calcium carbonate. Right? So one more example is PbNO3. Twice called lead nitrate. So when lead nitrate is heated, when you heat lead nitrate, it becomes PbO plus NO2 plus O2, PbO plus NO2 plus O2. So this lead nitrate is decomposed to form lead oxide, which is yellow in color, and you will get nitrogen dioxide, that is color will be brown fumes. So we are going to get the brown fumes of nitrogen dioxide. Why I am mentioning all the colors is because it's very important from the examination point of view, right? So I hope you guys understood thermal decomposition. Next, we shall discuss the next kind of reaction, that is known as electrolytic decomposition. We'll just write it. It is known as electrolytic decomposition. Electrolytic decomposition. So, what is electrolytic decomposition? Is our question. Guys, if a reaction, if a decomposition reaction is carried out by heating, then it is known as thermal decomposition. Similarly, if a decomposition reaction is carried out by using electricity, then that decomposition reaction is known as electrolytic decomposition. For example, you have water, you just pass electricity through water. What happens, guys? It is going to become hydrogen and oxygen. They are going to get separated. Right? So this is an example for electrolytic decomposition. That means we are going to apply electricity to form a decomposition reaction. This is basically a decomposition reaction. But in the decomposition reaction, what kind of decomposition reaction it is? It is an electrolytic decomposition. So electrolytic decomposition reaction means the electricity is used to carry out the decomposition reaction, right? So guys, you have to understand something about this electrolytic decomposition. I'm going to tell you through an experiment. You need to understand this. Guys, I have water. I'm going to make it as simple as possible. The experiment, please try to understand the experiment. I'm going to take water in a beaker and I am going to take two electrodes. Okay, I am going to take two electrodes. Suppose these are two electrodes. Are they? So I am going to take two test tubes. And put them in an inverted way, right? So I am going to take these two wires. Please try to understand this. I am going to take two wires from these electrodes and I am going to connect them to a magnet. Yes. And I have taken two electrodes. These two electrodes can be carbon rods or can be just iron nails. They act as electrodes. Then I have taken two test tubes, which is represented by the blue color. What I have taken, I have just put the two test tubes in an inverted position, right? And I have connected the battery, right? So when you just put this switch on, what happens is in these inverted test tubes, the bubbles will be collected. What you are going to get is bubbles will be collected here. Here also it will be collected, but here it will be less. Right? In the two test tubes, the bubbles of some gas will be collected. But in this test tube, the bubbles is more. In this test tube, the bubbles collected will be less. When you pass electricity through water, what is happening, guys? In the two electrodes, there are bubbles are collecting. That bubbles are nothing but gases. One is hydrogen and one is oxygen. In one test tube, the more number of bubbles are getting collected. In the other test tube, only less number of bubbles are getting collected. Why? Right? So the test tube in which more number of bubbles are collected, that gas is hydrogen. That gas is what? Hydrogen. And the test tube, the bubbles where less number of bubbles are collected, that gas is oxygen. That gas is oxygen. Now you can see that by comparing the amount of gas collected here and here, you can say that the amount of gas collected in this test tube, I will just call this test tube as A. For your convenience, I will call this test tube as A. This I will call it as B. The amount of gas collected in test tube A is double than the amount of gas collected in test tube B. Right? How much? If it is 2 gram is collected, here it will be 1 gram. So whatever is collected here, it will be double than that. Why? Why the amount of gas collected in this will be double than that of this? In other words, why the amount of hydrogen gas collected in one test tube is more here but the oxygen is less? That is because of the equation, that is H2O gives rise to H2 plus O2, but this is not balanced. This is not balanced. If you just balance this, what happens? Here we are going to get 2H2O, here we are going to get 2H2O, and here we are going to get 2H2, and here we are going to get only one oxygen molecule is there, right? So I have balanced this. Two molecules of H2O, when you pass electricity through it, two molecules of H2O form and one molecule of O2 is formed. Here you can say that for every two molecules of water, for every two molecules of water, two molecules of hydrogen are formed, and only here nothing is there, what will be there guys? One. So one molecule of oxygen is formed, right? For every two molecules of water, one molecule of hydrogen, two molecules of hydrogen, and one molecule of water is formed. So therefore, the gas collected at H2A will be double than that of the H2B. That gas is hydrogen. Okay, so that is your electrolytic reaction. Next comes your photolytic decomposition. Next one is photolytic decomposition. Photolytic. Photo means light. Photolytic decomposition. So if a decomposition reaction is carried out in the presence of sunlight, in the presence of what? Sunlight. Then that reaction is known as the photolytic decomposition. Is known as what? Photolytic decomposition. For example, this you take silver chloride. Silver chloride, AgCl, is silver chloride. When you take some silver chloride, which is white in color, you just put in sunlight. So what happens is, guys, the silver and chlorine, they get decomposed, they get separated, right? So AgCl becomes Ag and Cl2. Cl2 will be different. This white color will become gray color. Similarly, if you take silver bromide and you put it that into sunlight, what happens? Again you are going to get Ag plus, you are going to get Br2. So guys, these reactions, that is photolytic decomposition reactions, are used in black and white photography. Black and white photography. Black and white photography. That these decomposition reactions are used in where? Black and white photography. Right? So I hope you understood what is a combination reaction. I hope you understood what is the exothermic reaction. I also hope you understood the decomposition reaction. In the decomposition reaction, you have a thermal decomposition, you have electrolytic decomposition, as well as you have a photolytic decomposition.